Are they blowing holes? Like, are they mining something? Oh, shit. Devastator. Rotate turret!
And fire! All weapons operational. Time to get it moving, and be quick about it. No daydreaming.
Soon this demon will be up and running.
Deathbringer.
Deathbringer to fill out the ranks.
All right.
Has to be one of the Deathbringers Olin talked about. Fitting name. I'll never get into that tower. Unless I destroy that thing first.
My focus. It stopped working.
I've disabled his focus.
That grass isn't moving on its own.
I'll handle it.
Go!
All right, time to go.
Steam's blasting out. I wonder if those are weak points.
Trying to hit him with at least some Terra Blast arrows, cause to knock some of his parts off. I'm guessing he doesn't have any parts, cause I don't see nothing flying off. So. Alright, switch to fire arrows, because that thing did say he was weak to fire arrows, so. Oh crap, keep it moving. Gotta switch to potions. Alright, might be time to plant some of these traps. Hopefully they'll get somebody. Right. Switch up here. Cause I can't stay on the moving and drop these people. That's something I can do. Keep moving. Yep, it's a good thing we bought all those potions. I will say that. Alright. Probably don't have to kill him, but... at least there's cover right here. Alright, can he shoot through this? That's what's up. No, he cannot. Okay, cool. We found ourselves a vantage point. Alright, weaknesses to fire and electricity. Alright, let's try some of these. Man, this ain't doing shit. Wasting my time with that. Okay. There we go. That's what we need to hit. Let's try this. Let's try fire air. Ah, I broke it. Okay. This ain't doing no good. Just go with regular arrows. Seemed to do a whole lot more damage.
Hitting that thing really hurt it.
Yes, it did. Alright, what you gonna pull out next? Ooh, that's different. Down you go. Deathbringer was kind of weak. I was expecting more of a challenge. You know, with a name like the Deathbringer, I thought it was going to do something. Didn't even have to waste all my potions. Wasted more arrows and everything, but I'm glad I made them. I'll leave that guy alive to tell the story. Oh, this red-haired chick, she just came in here and whooped all of her asses. You should have seen her.
Got too much already.
She was nice with a bow. You know, we had no defense against her techniques. Can I pick my trap back up? Nope, guess not. All right, what did you have on you? Coil, shocks, braiding. Okay. Some useful stuff, at least. Alright, kill the cultists. Okay, so I gotta... They're gonna make me kill that one guy? I can't leave nobody alive to tell the story? Alright. Where was he at? Yeah, see, it's like sometimes people must be glitched. Because it's like, see how he's like not doing anything, even though I'm right here in front of him?
What are they shooting?
Come on, dude, stop moving. Let me kill you, please.
You will not escape the...
Won't escape the what now? Okay.
Did it. Those things pack a punch. All right. That Eclipse officer had a focus. Let's see what's on it. Let's see what you have to say.
Wah, 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 wah. Talk like Charlie Brown and whatnot.
What is this?
The entity lives. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. Unacceptable.
What the hell was that? Hades? Hey! Mysterious stranger, did you see that? No answer, huh? Figures. Things just keep getting stranger. I need to find a way inside the tower.
Okay, so am I the entity?
But I can squeeze through.
Oh, look at this loading screen. Ooh, a vault. Found one of these before in the open world.
Hold for identity scan.
One of these again.
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
Wow, that machine must be broke. I mean, unless I'm like a clone of my mom, which could be possible. I'm just saying, it should have read that my genetics weren't a 99 point something match. I'm just saying, because I'm not her. Unless I'm a clone. I mean, it should have recognized like a partial match, you know, a daughter, a sibling, something like that.
355,510 days overdue. Your meeting with Mr. Fairman. Please proceed to the 35th floor.
Wait. 350,000? That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
Well, it could be that mom turned herself into an AI, or she built a computer program, and it could be a bunch of things. Or she became technologically immortal. Maybe used some nanomachines in her body, you know, became a machine. Could be that too. Hopefully now they'll explain the robotic dinosaurs and all that good stuff. Okay, can't do nothing with this stuff. Alright, we probably gotta find out where we gotta go and turn something on. Let me just keep it moving. Was gonna try to look around, but it doesn't seem like I can see anything with the focus or interact with anything, so just keep it pushing.
A Deathbringer. Or a statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill. And they honored it?
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions.
Where more all like the built it.
Tomorrow are being solved.
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people, not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your focus. They'll help you understand.
What, no video? Like, just doing straight text files, huh? Where's like the HP video? Where's my 4K video resolution with this thing? Got me hoofing it upstairs.
The air. There's no smell to it. Not even old death.
Nothing. That's because it's probably sterile.
Another cave-in.
Ooh.
But I could get through.
Receptionist level brain, wow. Damn. Somebody was an asshole. Uh-uh. Let me back in. Let me back in. Damn it. Tried to jump back in the doorway.
To get back up.
Oh, okay, so am I leaving out now or? Nope, going back up again. Alright, so do I take the ladder and go back up? That's where I came from. Unless this was the exit.
Looks like I can climb here.
Okay, so I gotta probably make my way across. Alright, how am I gonna make my way up over there? Ooh. I will take most of that. Oh, busted my ass. Not as sure-footed as I thought. Alright, so I probably gotta climb on something else once I get up there. Because it looks like I could probably climb on these here, and then maybe go around. Like, let me drop down because I don't want to go back up there. Okay, well, can I drop down? There we go. Thank you. Trying to go. Looks like I probably got to go across. Ah, damn it. Okay. All right, let's try this again. Because I doubt I could probably just jump this gap and jump up there. So I probably got to climb up to that one, then jump over to that one. There we go. Now it wants to take me over there. Did the same thing last time and it didn't do nothing. Really didn't need to turn around right there, but, you know, trying to look fancy for the boys. Let's take a look around first before we go up. Ooh, that looks important. You know what would suck? I just thought about something. If, like, what if all the machines were people at one point? Like, not like people became machines or anything like that, but let's say, like, this, whatever this impending doom was, or let's say people who didn't want to take whatever the pills that they were talking about before, let's say they put their consciousness inside a machine, and a lot of people, let's say, did that. So that's why every machine, you know, you see wandering around, they're like animalistic, but let's say their programming, so to speak, was, let's say, people's brain scans. Alright, so they added more security.
People were angry at Faro, at the corporation. They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
Maybe that big cataclysm they were talking about? This looks like a holographic map room or something.
The ACA-3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance, it boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile manipulator arm that can handle a host of functions. From 360-degree less lethal riot management to surgical repairs of allied chariot line models. And you've got the workhorse of any cutting-edge peacekeeping fleet.
The Corruptor. Slave enemy robots to its own network. It sounds like it's talking about how it corrupts machines.
Of course it is. That was a presentation. They were trying to sell that bad boy. All right, time to go up.
Way up. What's left of it? Gonna be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobeck. If plants can find a way to hang on up here, guess I can too.
Well, you're not a plant, so... Just saying, they don't really get tired. Photosynthesis and all that good stuff. And unless you're like the humans from Knights of Cydonia, we cannot photosynthesize.
This began when they engaged in unauthorized offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes. And by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now, what I can promise you, can absolutely assure you, is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue. So when you hear the bad talk about us against this company in the days, maybe weeks to come, just bear in mind that we will get past this. That a day's coming when none of this will matter.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
Alright, so they put out the machines and they couldn't control them. Apparently. That wouldn't kill all of humanity though, so. Still kind of curious as far as what did them. All hands on deck. Who's still half sober and on the bar. All right.
cold.
So it is. You know, they better have like an easy way of getting down from all this. Because I'm not going all the way back through here. Wait, can I continue to climb up? No. They want me to find Ted Farrow's office, but like, what if his office isn't even there? You know, I'm just saying. Like, this place is all falling apart. His office could be on the ground level right now. It used to be up top, but now, you know, it fell off. They don't know. They better give me some badass upgrade for climbing this thing. Just saying, throwing it out there. Like, I better, you know, upgrade my ability to, like, remotely scan machines and convert them or some shit. Alright, this way, okay. Ooh! That was close. I didn't think I was gonna make it.
Can't carry more.
Like, not to get graphic, but it looks like what happens inside of a blender, as if a robot was whipping up a big pink swirling milkshake of dolphin chunk. Damn. They killed those dolphins? Ah, well. I'm sure dolphin meat tastes just as good as anything else. Intelligent or not.
Way up. All it takes is a few good handholds. All right, made it. Wonder what we'll find.
This looks like a boardroom.
All data has been erased from this device. Do you wish to deploy either privileges to recover purged data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
A file has been recovered.
Okay. All right, there's Mom. Elizabeth, I'm guessing that's Ted.
It's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your daddy confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
Your killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes, those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data then. And we'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Farrow brought Elizabeth Sobeck here, but they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
Man, then, you know, then just say, hey, I recovered two files. How about that?
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
So that's what happened.
Capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture.
They used humans as fuel. Damn.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean?
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
Alright, so how did they solve the problem? Yeah, Ted, you fucked up big time, bruh.
Robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
Any third files? Yeah, thought so. Let's see how they solve the problem.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I am speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
Is this one of those situations where...
What made her solution so terrible?
Is this one of those things where, in order to stop the robots, you have to stop their food?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
Did they kind of do what the Forerunners did in Halo, where it's like, hey, look, we can't stop it, but we can stop their food source? Or at least put people in vaults or do whatever they have to do.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the old ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that feral robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Silence, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
All right, Silence, you've made your point. I came to these ruins hoping to learn more about this Elizabeth Sobek. And I have, but I still don't understand my connection to her. Or why the Eclipse is trying to kill me. Or who Hades is. No answers, just one question after another.
Exactly. Which is why it's time to expand your frame of inquiry. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobek.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that Pharaoh robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
You're insufferable, you know that? Let's get on with this. Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asaram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a Metal Devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved. Well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least. U.S. Robot Command next, to learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Come on, I thought I was gonna have like a faster rappel, man. They can't just give me one where I just jump down the straight building, you know, just the whole way. Here we go. Oh shit, hit the wrong button. I thought the game was gonna kind of automatically take me into it, but no. They had to give me the Assassin's Creed treatment. Oh well. Look at it this way, maybe they might load me up at the bottom. Who knows? And no, they didn't. Okay. Okay. This time, let me not jump to my impending doom. What was that behind me?
Forget about traveling light.
Alright, this time I'm not going to make the same mistake. Alright, fellas, let me end this video here. And in the next one, we're going to check out this Grave Horde and see what mysteries and discoveries lie in store for us. So, my name is Denanu, the man with the biggest and the most blackest privilege on YouTube. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.